Sweeping both Delano Pole Awards in Australia is Michael Sykes in the number 5 car for Alert. Carlos Requeta makes his first appearance on the front row in Yulian Asova's car number 7. Or rather, the car that used to be Yulian Asova's. Interestingly enough, Roketa's teammate, Yevgeny Kuznetsov, qualified in only 34th, but he was sent to the back of the grid with a grid penalty. You will notice there in row 5, Jacob Card is taking Packer Carroll's place. That's because Packer was actually suspended from this race after basically failing to brake for a caution at Victoria. So Packer's not even at the racetrack today. That's how frustrating the situation is for him. To add insult to injury, Packer Carroll has officially been released from Volpe after this season. Alessandro Rossini will be driving that car, and I think that's fantastic for the series. Team Saar USA will also be back in the series next year, and they have announced their two drivers will be Joe Alenik and Cameron Taylor. So it'll be good to see those two boys driving for Team Saar USA, and I think they've got a lot of work ahead of them. There you see all four cars that have been given grid penalties for the race: Ian Cooper, Kuznetsov, Benoit Vukler, and Ash Bridges. This track here at Fraser Coast is very slow and very winding, and we expect a very interesting race, whereas track position will be critical. Dan, off to you. Thanks, Lance. Here we have car number 5, the red 5 of Michael Sykes, and the red and gold number 7 of Carlos Requeta, who gets a terrible start in that very underpowered Katsev, and Gaspar D'Souza in that black and teal car begins to attack already. Requeta is punching well above his weight, but as Lance mentioned, Kuznetsov would have qualified way in the back even if he didn't get a time penalty, or rather a grid penalty, sorry. And, well, Requeta, clearly the more impressive of the two Katsev drivers all throughout the weekend. He's been in the top 10 in most of the practice sessions, and this kid is really showing a lot of people up, especially because a lot of people said, oh, well, Raketa's only in it for the money, but I think he's got quite a bit of talent there anyways. Here is Zelda Ashby in the 55 car, still in the championship hunt, with a sort of Iron Man-like performance as Ashby just continues to reel off. Duff is off the road in the 74 car. Zach Duff, a man whose seat might be under threat somewhat as he drops through the field. There's that yellow car over there on the left. That's Matthias Taub, the championship leader. He had a disastrous race in Victoria. Didn't even really last too long before that car gave up the ghost. But Taub trying to fight back here today, not really having the best of starts. Zach Duff in the 74. His ride may be in doubt for next season. Here, back at the front of the field, the battle for a second between Gaspar D'Souza and Leonard Roderick. I think Gaspar D'Souza, a little bit off the road. Oh, maybe a little contact there with the 7 car. And look at that orange car, the second orange car, car number 70, Mika Possen in his back to drive in the third Alert car, because I think Michael Sykes, short answer, needs an extra wingman, and Chris Davenport's not cutting the mustard over there, so Mika Possen drafted in. Here's Jacob Card in car number 2, replacing Packer Carroll, and really, Jacob Card has been running in TM Lights for quite a while. He really hasn't had too much success. Roderick is off in the 4 car! So Leonard Roderick goes off the road. Now what happened here? Roderick in the 4 car, maybe just, wonder if there's, no, he just got onto the grass. Oh, okay then. So Roderick has lost the front end of that car, trying to avoid Requeta possibly, and then just, okay. Well, Roderick in the 4 car has got a bit of a setback there. But anyways, with where I was going with Jacob Card, he's had he's been running in TM Lights for a while, never really had a whole lot of success. Oh no! We got a problem for Roqueta. He's called into the pits. We got a cut tire on the 7 car. Big disappointment for Roqueta. He qualified so well, but to have to pit for a puncture this early is going to really kill his race. And it's really a shame for Roqueta because he has starred all throughout practice and qualifying. Matthias Taub is going backwards. He's all the way back in 18th after starting 14th. But look at Kevin Dwyer going 3 wide on the outside in that bright blue 72. As he's trying to make his way around Scott Bates in the 88 car, the custom cards entry, that sort of dark red and silver car, trying to make a run on Taub. And that 88 car is even making his way forwards. Kevin Dwyer going
forward. I'm looking for the mole people.
I don't talk to mole sympathizers.
Okay, so Ebenezer Quiggles Jr. has got mole people. Anyways, there goes Troy Adams, a local hero on the 18 car. He's trying to redeem himself after a disastrous race at Calder Park. as Kevin Dwyer trying to clear the points leader. Dwyer doesn't really seem to care about the championship at all, and he said he's not going to move over for anyone. And here's Chris Davenport going off the track in a blue car this week. Davenport's had more paint jobs this year than he has good finishes, and I think Davenport might be wanting to reverse that trend. Granted, he's got another paint job, we believe, for the October races. Here's Ash Bridges in car number 30. He was actually faster than the 79 car of Archer Harris in qualifying, and actually, the 79 car of Archer Harris shouldn't have even qualified for this race because he was outside 110% of the fastest car in all the practice sessions and in qualifying. Ash Bridges at least made 110% in first practice, and that's why he's starting today, rather than being on the sidelines. Here is Mika Possinen, who's worked his way up to second. Ashby hunting him down in third. Jacob Card running in fourth. Great start for the Toronto native, as Roderick right behind his teammate. Roderick, now no team orders over at Volpe, but Ashby really looking to get by Possinen as Possinen defends. Mika Possinen trying to help Michael Sykes' championship bid, but he's doing a very, very good job of doing that at least. As here comes the 55 around the 70, but Possinen fights back on the inside. Off goes the 55. No contact there. Ashby just got under the grass, it looks like. Here's Archer Harris in the Tenere. That's a black 79 car. No sponsor on that. There's a Manticore off the track that looks like... Oh, no! Stoidler's gotten into Bridges... Or Stoidler's gotten into Harris. Harris goes off the road. And that's going to be another setback for the Clayson Enterprises car. This really epitomizes their weekend. Archer's been off the track almost as much as he's been on it. Here's Scott Stoidler. Oh, there was contact with the 50 car. Oh, Stoidler not happy about that. I think he just tried to take the 50 out right there. That was Ben Atkins in the number 52 Tino. And then he just cuts across the grass like an absolute madman and just takes the 79 out. Now, that's a little petulant in my opinion, but... what's even crazier is that there's no penalty being issued for that. Scott Bates in the 88 car is sitting up in 12th. He's still an outside threat for the title, even though he's going to need a little bit of help in order to actually get it. Here is Lewis Kingston in the 17 car. That's 17 of Kingston having a strong run right now. Talking about strong runs, Davina Henton in car number 11. Another disastrous qualifying effort for the Lynx Racing car number 11. But she's, again, as has been the trend, climbing through the field very quickly. Here's Melanie Klebno, the other Lynx car, running up in ninth. Both the Lynx cars are title threats, and Davina Henton's has really seemed to make the most out of these sort of come-from-behind drives. Melanie Klebno has never put herself in the position to really do that, but she's just had too many mechanical failures, it seems, in this slow. Oh, contact! Oh, she got turned around by the double zero, slides across! Arto Kekkonen involved in car number 9. And Klebno off, Kekkonen off. That's a lot of damage to the 12 car and to the 9. I dare say that this is going to put Melanie Klebno's championship bid to a screeching halt. Going to bring it to a halt right there because that's going to be some pretty lengthy repairs. I have a feeling they'll try to get this car back out, but let's see what happened here. Yeah, Gasper just came in there like a bull in a china shop, runs over the 12 car, and then right across Arto Kekkonen's bows. And they're going to look at that one after the race. Oh, more problems with Carlos Rocheta. He's pitting the 7 car again. Yeah, this is, honestly, I think at this point, Rocheta might be best off parking it. He's not running any more races for the rest of the season. As Peter Short in the 22 car is running into problems, and it looks like this 22 car will be on early retirement as well. Actually, nobody's dropped out of the race yet. So, yep, smoke billowing out the back of that car. Peter Short's day done. As here is Michael Sykes in the red 5, having a very comfortable lead right now in the red 5. He's retiring at the end of the season, so what a better way to go out from a very, very successful driving career than with a championship. Here's another man who has won quite a few accolades in his career so far. Bad Uncle Melrose, car number 67. Oh, no, but he's not going to get an engineering award because, or at least his team isn't, because they've broken down right now. MRT will be full-time in 2014. He's trying to wiggle that car to get it refired. No luck there. But here's Ebenezer Quiggles Jr. on board with him. As there you see Melrose's car. that's Melrose did a good thing and didn't and kept it where it was, so that he gave everyone else time to move out of the way. And
pretty kitty, pretty kitty, crazy, crazy, crazy. What was I doing?
FPO's had some interesting new hires as of late, to be on top of their pit boxes, in case you haven't noticed. Right. Anyways, Ebenezer Quiggles Jr., great Rob, great avoidance there, but he's been having a disastrous week, too. Here's Melanie Cleveland. A lot of repairs done to that 12 car. She's not racing anyone for position. As Lance mentioned earlier, Alessandro Rossini will drive this car next year. But Jacob Card is putting on a fine show so far, as he is trying to contend for he's trying to contend for a podium right now. It's on the offer. A top five result certainly is. So Jacob Card, the young Canadian, he's been running in TM Lights for a long time, not a whole lot of success, and none of Volpe's other reserve drivers were available. Robert Dorian, Dash Cup commitments, Chris Johans, Manicor Engineering, and Rachel Rainsford, his other commitments. Ali Collada's name has not come up, so I can only suspect that Collada has been officially let go after really not impressing for them in preseason testing, and that's kind of a shame, really. Here is, looking at the other Katsev, I think, this is Kuznetsov, who is Gino Kuznetsov, slowly making his way through the field. Kuznetsov, very much a fan favorite, but he's had his share of difficulties this year. He's trying to make up for it here in the race when it matters, and the very popular Russian working around Chris Davenport in the 6 car. Davenport, who's planning to do his hair up in pink again for October. That'll be interesting. That caused a minor uproar in the TM Lights paddock a couple years ago when he did that first. As Lewis Kingston goes into the outfield and back on track, and Kingston in that 17 car. He's had more success than his sponsor, but as you see there, Matthias Taub looks like he's doing his best to lose the championship. Either that or this number 10 car is just not handling very well. I think the latter might be a bit more correct there. As Kingston in the 17 car, he's got Arto Kekkonen in front of him. Now the 9 car, not racing him for position. There's a mark on the side of the 1 car of Adrian Devereaux. Now I think that came from... I'm not quite sure where that came from, but hopefully we'll figure that out before this one's over. As Kingston in car number 17, working his way around Zach Duff in the 74 car. This 17 car, he's really been flirting with the track boundaries this week. And Kingston has got quite a bit of talent and quite a bit of speed in this car, but just hasn't really had a whole lot of luck. Here's Kurt Pliskin in car number 16, and if we want to talk about unlucky, Kurt Pliskin is closing in, actually, on Stephanie McGlynn's honor for most DNFs in a season, which McGlynn... Pliskin pits the pit... Oh, no, he's gotten into the pit wall! Kurt Pliskin bailed for the pit lane, and Troy Adams goes tumbling down the main straight. Pliskin bailed for the pit lane. I don't know if there was a mechanical problem on that car suddenly. It looked like that was the case, because that was very sudden. It looked like he might have smelled. Smelled something burning in there, and he might have bailed it for the pit lane. As we're on board with Craig Mummert in the 114 car, the Middle Tennessee Motorsports entry. A little surprised they made the trip down here, but yeah, Troy Adams in it. Now, what's even more surprising is that they didn't bring the red flag out for this, because this has almost completely blocked the main straight. We're looking at Rob Nelson in the 06 car. Car in front of him is Ricketta, who he's not racing for position with. Nelson, not a whole lot of experience, but you see Nelson on the brakes, he's got the 7 car with him, and Nelson misses it. There you see, Ricketta brings it to a stop just to miss that, and that really should have been a red flag. I have no idea why it wasn't. Casper D'Souza in the 00, of course that incident he had with Melanie Cleveno is going to be looked at after the race. I have a feeling I know what's headed his way, and it starts with 30 seconds, meaning a time penalty. There is the 10 car of Taub right with him, as we've got the 5 car of Michael Sykes hitting the pit lane. The red 5 is the first car to pit, looks like. 70 car stayed out. There you see also, the Volpes have stayed out. A lot of cars have stayed out. Greg Woodard is in the 41 Phoenix Performance Lycoya. As Woodard throwing the dice, it looks like there. Here's Mika Pasta in car number 70. Now, he's pitting a lap after Michael Sykes. I don't know why Sykes pitted as early as he did. I think it's going to be more beneficial if you stay out later. Scott Bates in the 88 car, Davina Henson in the 11, staying out very long. Henton in the 11 was the last car to make a pit stop here. Oh, the 72 car stayed out as well. So, looking ahead here at the race leader, that is Mika Pasanen, car number 70, and that, your eyes are not deceiving you. Running in second, Jacob Card. Oh, he's gotten into Benoit Vuckler. He's gotten into the Tutino. Pasanen ran over the Tutino of Benoit Vuckler, who he was lapping, and Vuckler goes off the course. And he didn't really make any effort to pass Vuckler, he just decided to turn him. But at the same time, he was getting hustled by Card. These are two guys who are not regulars in the series. This is Card's fourth Master Cup start. And actually, every single one of Jacob Card's Master Cup series attempts has been with a different team. And there you see Vuckler just chops off the leader, Mika Pasanen. No idea what he is doing. And I think at this point, Mika Pasanen is getting frustrated. Vuckler goes off to take his regular racing line, and Mika Pasanen does, I think, what I'm going to start calling the Adrian Devereaux maneuver, and just puts him off into the sand pit. Referring to, of course, Adrian Devereaux's antics at the Round of England, where several of the teams at the back of the grid ended the race being very infuriated with him because Devereaux was shoving so many of the lap cars off the track and caused quite a bit of damage. But was not penalized for any of it. Again, all of that to lapped cars. As Jacob Card tries to reel in Mika Pasanen, and that encounter with Benoit Vuckler is really going to help Mika Pasanen's case. Vuckler in the 48 car in this race with the promoter's option. As Card in the 2 car trying to reel in the 70, who's also in this race with the promoter's option. Jacob Card. Driving for Volpe, he's trying to impress here, but Luciano Savarol is hanging back there in third. This is a pretty good run from Luciano. He's leaving Hodges Walter Racing at the end of the season, but Hodges Walter is definitely dedicated to getting him a win before the season's out. His home race is coming up, and I think there'd be nothing bigger than Luciano winning the Round of Brazil. And if you think I'm kidding, then, well, the Brazilians do take home crowd very, very seriously. Luciano Savarol in car number 3, that bright green car. We're not sure what team he'll be moving to next season. Zelda Ashby in the 55 car has dropped a little bit. Oh, going off the track again. No, get back on course. There we go. That car a bit of a handful right now. Here is Kevin Dwyer, who's having a very solid run of his own. There you see Michael Sykes right behind him. Sykes had a disastrous pit stop. I don't think Sykes and the alert team are going to be at all happy with that. But Kevin Dwyer in the 72 car, definitely I think he'll be happy about how his run's going. As you see Michael Sykes right behind him, Lewis Kingston, that 17 car closing in. And then there's another blue car. I think that's Greg Woodard, actually. But yes, it is. Greg Woodard having a great run back there, as is the driver of this car, Davina Henton, who is really jumping her way through the field. In car number 11, the Lynx Gessler. I say Lynx Gessler because that's what these cars are powered with. They're the same Gessler engines that are in the two Carl Richter factory cars. So cars 11 and 12. In case some people have been wondering why they've been so strong this year, that's, I think, may have something to do with it. Because that car, it handles very well, but they seem to give up a lot in the straights. Which is kind of surprising, considering the Gessler engine of that car. As we've got Vuckler. Oh, Vuckler shoved him off! Vuckler squeezed! Pasanen off the road! Oh, there's that payback or what? Benoit Vuckler just squeezes Mika Pasanen off the racetrack. And here comes Jacob Card in the 2 car right on by. And Card into the lead of the race, largely because Benoit Vuckler is driving like a 10-year-old, to put it, I can't really put it any better than that. You're being lapped, get out of the way. And there's Melanie Clevno in car number 12. And Melanie lets Card go, and she's going to let the 70 car go. There you see Melanie Clevno showing how you're supposed to react when you're a back marker, and not driving like a complete idiot like Benoit Vuckler has so far. Luciano Savarol goes right on by Clevno as well. Here is Michael Sykes in car number 5, closing in on Scott Bates. Bates is not going to make life easy for Michael Sykes. Scott Bates, you're going to have to work to get around him. But as Michael Sykes, it looks like he set him up just perfectly. Textbook perfect. Made Scott Bates pick his line, and then Sykes went the other way. And there you see Sykes just scream right on by the 88 car. Bates made him work for it. As Benoit Vuckler continues to not know what a mirror is, I'm surprised he hasn't been pulled off the racetrack, because clearly this is a man who doesn't understand what the blue flag means. Vuckler in the 48 car, now he's going off the racetrack. Oh no, look out, look out! Oh, he gets into Kingston, and Vuckler spins himself around. And really, this is getting out of hand at this point. Benoit Vuckler's really should be pulled off the racetrack, because this is some of the most disgraceful driving I've seen in quite some time. Kevin Dwyer in the 72 car, hunting down Adrian Devereaux in the 1, and Davina Henton is up there as well. So, there you see, so that's where they all are in relation to Vuckler. As I think Devereaux may have anticipated Vuckler bouncing back into the middle of the track. Pretty good prediction there, considering where he's been this weekend. Here's Chris Johans having a pretty good run. He's running solidly in the points in this Manicor Engineering 29 car. And he's really putting his two teammates into the shade. Granted, that's nothing new. He's been doing that all season. But here, especially, Chris Johans is showing that he is deserving of a top-line car. Davina Henton in the 11, Adrian Devereaux in the 1, side by side. Henton swings it wide, goes a bit off the track, but Adrian Devereaux is going to go right on by, because the Colt Merle Altair is, quite a bit stronger than the Lynx L313. And Devereaux scoots on away, and he's going to challenge Kingston as Possenin pits first. As you see, Card and Soverall stay out. Ben Atkins has gone a lap down, and Sykes is in too, along with Greg Woodard. That's Greg Woodard in the background. That blue and white car. There's a couple blue and white cars in the field, but Woodard's car is the stripe going across the hood. Lewis Kingston doing battle with Adrian Devereaux. Devereaux brushes him off. Same place, too. Adrian Devereaux led nearly the entire race here last year, and he really sort of toyed with the rest of the field. It was one of his 6 wins on his way to the championship last year. Meanwhile, Jacob Card, I don't think too many people would have predicted Jacob Card could be in a position to win this race, but Luciano Soverall, I think, is a little bit quicker here at the end of the run. Card in car number 2 is going to pit. Luciano, I think Luciano pits with him. Yes, he does. Just the Brazilian is so quick on pit in as well. Here's Roderick, the second Volpe, leaving the pits. Car number 4 is traditional orange car. Roderick comes out right in front of Possenin, so Possenin's decision to pit early is clearly backfiring. And Possenin sliding behind Roderick. I think Roderick is kind of spying himself, because he used to drive that car last year. As Jacob Card has got in just in this final stint of the race, Jacob Card's got a solid lead over Luciano Soverall. But I've noticed, Ash Bridges in the 30 car is sliding around. He's been off the track himself, but great recovery by Kuznetsov, who started 40th there, to be up in 21st. But Jacob Card, he's a little bit slower than Luciano Soverall, who is slowly eating away at his lead. As there's Ash Bridges, there's Michael Sykes, there is the three car Luciano. And Rocchetta! So that's a replay of where the damage was caused to the 30 car. Carlos Rocchetta got punted, it looks like. Either that or he came screaming in like a madman. And we're about to see where that came from. Rocchetta goes off the course, comes back on, cuts off the 88 car. Rocchetta just comes flying and thinks he's going to make it stick, and he doesn't. And I'm going to have to say that's Rocchetta's fault, especially because Rocchetta's a lap down. And really shouldn't have been. That was a bit overambitious. Sykes gets it going again, but look at the 70. Look at Mika Possenin swinging it around wide to try to get third back from Roderick. Possenin wants the podium. He wants it bad, because his career might depend on it. Here he comes on the inside of Roderick, trying to get around the 4-time Master Cup champion. Roderick fights back, though. Two orange cars here, almost too much orange. And it's a good thing Ian Cooper's still in the race, because then there'd be way too much orange in that shot. Anyways, Roderick setting up, and there goes Ash Bridges. At least Ash Bridges is being courteous. even if he is picking some rather interesting lines around the racetrack. Davina Henton up here in the 11 car, having a very strong run. Henton qualified very, very poorly, and she's really made the most of it. It's going to get a top 10 finish if she keeps it on the gray stuff. And Davina Henton has shown a fair ability to do that, actually, throughout the season. She seemed to crack under pressure when it came to having the championship lead, but when it comes to pursuing, it seems to be something Davina Henton has a knack for. And that is a skill that that must be appreciated, especially considering what she's had to work with. And Quiggles Jr. off the road. Wonder if there's a problem with that car. Oh, he cut off Rossini. He cut off Alessandro Rossini. And the Tutino is in trouble, as is Quiggles Jr. Quiggles Jr. out of the race. Rossini way down now. And I think Rossini is not going to be terribly happy with Quiggles Jr. Henton makes a pretty ambitious move there around, Duff's a lap down, I think. 74 car has been in the pits for a while. They've had some mechanical difficulties with that car. Roderick fights back on Pasanen, trying to get that position back, trying to catch Luciano Savaral. Jacob Card has been steadily slowing down as Luciano is slowly reeling him in. And Roderick is now reeling him in as well, as is Pasanen, but these two racing each other is not going to help their case. Here they come around. Ben Atkins in the 50 car. Let's hope he's paying attention. The 50 car slides off the racetrack. No, he's not. Roderick shoves Atkins off the road. Ben Atkins driving like a bit of a lunatic as he just turned right into the 4 car, but Pasanen swings it around the outside. Pasanen back to third. Great battle between these two cars here at towards the end of the race, but Pasanen took advantage of Ben Atkins driving like a fool into the side of Roderick when Roderick clearly was bearing down on him. It's amazing how little some of these guys at the back of the grid use their mirrors. As Pasanen now, he's going to have to deal with Roderick again. He's not clear. Roderick might have... I think Roderick may have given him a bumper a little bit. Pasanen holding on. Pasanen's going to make him work for it, but Roderick may have the inside as they come through the last corner down to the main straightaway. Cars 70 and 4. Luciano ahead of them. Savaral closing in on the leader, Jacob Card, as the end of the first turn. As Pasanen not giving up. Roderick not giving up either. Roderick squeezing him out just a little bit, and Roderick's going to take the spot. No, not quite. Here comes Pasanen, but no. Pasanen goes a bit wide. Roderick stays in third. Roderick hangs on to third, as we've got another battle here between Davina Henton and Zelda Ashby. Both of these cars are title contenders. Ashby in a much safer position as Ashby squeezes the 11 car out wide, and Ashby takes the position. I'm pretty sure this is a battle for fifth place. There's been so much going on here, it's a little hard to keep track of everything, as Greg Woodard and Michael Sykes do battle, and Sykes around the outside of Woodard. As there is the 11 car now that Sykes is closing in on. As we look off the back of Davina Henton's car, here comes the 5, the red 5 of Sykes, peeking his nose in anywhere he can, trying to give Davina Henton a run for her money. Here he comes, the red 5 on her left side. Michael Sykes trying to get in a pretty solid result for himself, but in every position for Sykes is going to mean more points. He's going to eat into Matthias Taub's lead. Taub has been nowhere all day. He's been in the lower points, so he's really not been much of a factor. This is a day that Sykes needs to capitalize on if he's going to eat into Taub's massive lead that he has in the championship coming into this race. Here, however, Jacob Card is going to pull off one of the biggest upsets in TM Master Cup Series history. Volpe called him in on the last minute. None of their reserve drivers were available to replace Packer Carroll. The Canadian, the very amiable Canadian, down the main straightaway, is going to win in his first race for Volpe. Card wins here in Australia, here at Queensland. Jacob Card in car number 2, an amazing display to bring that car home. P1, Luciano Savaral was gaining on Card half a second a lap in those past few laps, the last few laps of the race, but he didn't close in enough. Roderick wins that thrilling battle for third over Mika Pasanen. Scott Bates, Michael Sykes, Zelda Ashby, Davina Henton round up the top 8. Greg Woodard was following them in 9th, and Adrian Devereaux a distant 10th. Kingston and Kevin Dwyer solid runs. Gaspar D'Souza may have a points or a time penalty. Sorry, headed his way. I didn't mention anything about João Paulo Vidal, Darren Cardell, or Tom Moore, but all three of those drivers deserve a pat on the back for driving their way through the field as if they stole it. Chris Davenport seemed to be doing quite a bit of off-roading, but he managed to put his car on the gray stuff long enough to keep him to get himself up to 18th place. Evgeny Kuznetsov started all the way back in 40th place, but he fought his way bravely through the field. Round of applause for Kuznetsov for bringing home a 19th place. 2 points only, but that's still a fantastic drive for the Russian. And Matthias Taub started 14th, and he had a very dismal day, to say the least, and wound up only 20th. And let's have a look at Drivers' Championship as it stands, leaving the Australian Tour. Taub is finally within reach of another driver. Michael Sykes could take the championship lead in Brazil. Adrian Devereaux sits third, and Zelda Ashby is still a realistic title threat in fourth place. No wins, but leads the series in top 10 finishes. Taub himself only has one win. Sykes only has one. Devereaux has three. That could prove very decisive as the season goes on. Scott Bates in 6th place can't be counted out either, neither can Davina Hentschen, but they're both going to need quite a bit of help. Luciano Savarel and Leonid Roderick are a little bit too far back. Just imagine what Luciano's season could have been like if he didn't get those two DNFs after leading at France and at Road Atlanta very early in the season. Also keep in mind that Rookie of the Year battle is really heating up between Kuznetsov and Quiggles Jr., and that a good deal of these point standings, as you see here, are provisional, because remember, there is a time penalty that could be handed out to Gaspar D'Souza that could shake things up a little bit. A quick look at the Independence Trophy, even though we didn't really touch much on it today, is that Dan Lechleiter still has the lead, obviously. Ben Huron, Jacob Eichholz, stay where they are, obviously. Going down a little further, Tom Moore in the 52 is beginning to make some noise in the Big Mac racing car. He could be a bit of a wild card here. Moore kind of lost out on the Independence Trophy last year at the last race. Perhaps he could be in a position to jump on and take it this year. Rob Nelson and Barton Sandy, the two BKR Australia cars, both gave valiant efforts, but they actually gained a little bit in their Independence Trophy bids. Both of them will be present in Brazil. I don't think they're contenders to take Lechleiter's lead, but they could certainly make an impact. João Paulo Vidal in the 36 car is in a similar situation. The next race in the TM Master Cup Series campaign will take place at the Autódromo Daniel Estevam for the Round of Brazil. This is a track, of course, that not too many of the drivers are keen to return to, especially given some of the speeds we've seen this year, and given, of course, the very tragic accident that happened there in 2011.